watching brains go by. My, my, my. I'm an imposter. I'm an imposter. There goes one now. The high school I come from, I was valedictorian. Now I'm surrounded by genius. I was such a fool. Don't know how I got in this school. My self-esteem is in pieces. I'm an imposter. I'm an imposter. Watching brains go by. My, my, my. I'm an imposter. I'm an imposter. Here comes one now. Surrounded by Swatsy Lee. Could you please teach a little slower? Passed out on the grass. Tomorrow's final's gonna kick my ass. Can my ego go any lower? I'm an imposter. I'm an imposter. Watching brains go by. My, my, my. I'm an imposter. Imposter, there goes one now. I'm an imposter. I'm an imposter. Watching brains go by. My, my, my. I'm an imposter.
Hello, our newest caller, fellow actor Marty Spanninger. Marty, thanks for requesting the imposter. God, most people felt that way.
Well, it sure was the story of my freshman year. I quickly realized I wasn't going to be the hot shot I thought I was. I was from a public school in small town, Perkasie, PA. Freshman year. Was I the only virgin?
But you're not now a virgin?
I came to Swarthmore with outfits. Many I sewed for myself. Within week one, it was pretty clear I wasn't going to tell anyone that I'd been a cheerleader, and certainly never that I'd been a teenage Republican. My first weekend, I made a beeline to the Army Navy store and I bought flannel shirts, army pants, wallabies.
Oh, you look great in overalls, that farmer look.
Brian, you know me all too well, and you know how I suffer from FOMO. I like to be in on everything. And watching this, I'm feeling it big time. Am I the only one who missed Springsteen in the amphitheater sophomore year? And our one and only football win? Where was I? McCabe?
Well, maybe you were in Pearson, but it sounds like you could use some lightening up, some fun. So let's take a trip down the crumb together, to be followed by more academic anxiety in Frantically Coping.
Left all my friends in Willets, headed for the crumb on this day in May. Loaded down with oars and bags and plastic, thinking the regatta's mine to win. Makeshift rafts keep turning, crumb waters keep on churning. Falling, falling, falling. Rafts keep turning, crumb waters keep on churning. Falling, falling, falling in the river. Mm-hmm.
hoping we slouch toward the midterm and wander at the empty brain inside. Gasping at glimpses of genuine failure, we run, wishing we could hide. Only to wish we had actually tried. Wordlessly watching, she waits with the blue books and wonders at the empty faces' sides. Heartlessly helping herself to our bad dreams, she worries, will her curve be too high, or even too low?
This is one test grade. There are two to come.
Oh, that makes three together. They are four. Stairwell, you'll see something certain to tell you. Confusion has its cost. Facts aren't flying, they're left in a loose leaf that lingers right back in my dorm room. So I'm choking in my room.
Our next caller, fellow lax player, Maurice Carey Cairns.
Hey, Brian, great to see you. Thanks for having me on.
All right. Now, go soccer team. Maurice, you are a spirited spark plug on our championship spark, our soccer team, aren't you?
Well,
congrats.
I play defense, and mainly my job is to keep the other team from our goal and basically being a part of a wall that keeps the opponent's scoring opportunities down. But I hear the Jackson 5 have written a song about our team.
Yeah, they have. It's next up. But tell me, first, what is it like to scrimmage defense against the speedy Mac Todman?
Well, you know, basically, I think Mac takes it easy on his teammates. Mac's lightning in the bottle. And against the competition, he's ruthless, but in practice, he's in a lower gear. you know, he's a pure striker, agile and fast and with great ball handling skills, instinct for the goal. But if you know him off the field, he walks off the field, he's relaxed, gracious, and with a great sense of humor.
Oh, that is Mac Todman for sure. Well, thanks, Carey. And now let's all hear from Pass It to Mac.
Goes in the books.
they go. Now that tidal line's gonna stop. Pass it to Matt. Yes, they did now.
Pass it to Matt.
Playing great D now.
Pass it to Matt.
Breaking free now.
Pass it to Matt.
Look out, baby. Flying through record gear. They put their foes to shame. First swap programming in NCAA crown game. Mac makes all American. Team achieves renown. Back in 74, Swarthmore Hall of Fame's his own. Oh, baby, give them one more cheer.
Show me that you love them.
Watch them play with ease. We'll do our part. Oh, garnet making history as they go.
Baby.
Reaching national heights with such hearts.
Pass it to Mac. Pass it to Mac. Pass it to Mac.
Thank you, Jackson 5. Tribute to All-American Mac Todman. Let's share more team stories in the chat. You know, back in the preps, we used to help Todman call home long distance by playing a recording of quarters dropping into the payphone. That is, until the feds gave us a call. Next up, Jim Croce, operator.
Operator, where could you place my collect call? Gotta ring my folks cause they like to be updated. They live 5 states away and wanna know that I'm okay. So I'm at a Willets payphone and here I've waited. And if the phone's near your room, it blows. People calling nonstop to ask for a doormate if you can find them. Phone rings off the hook just about all the damn time. So you know I respond really slow so someone else can go. I wish we'd all had cells, not live through payphone hell. But that wasn't the deal, and that's just the way I feel.
Here's the Dinner Queen, followed by the very relaxing Chill.
Liver and onions, dances in the shop of life.
Chillin' up in McCane, late last night. Fell asleep in our chairs until the morning light, but we're still chilling. Well, we've been from Willets to Mary Lyon, from Wharton A to Halliwell. We've had every kind of drink that's ever been made. Even been to Dio, but we didn't get laid. Weed and white wine, and we have a good time, then we'll be willing to be grooving.
Next up, Crib Note Friend. Final song in the set, and then we'll be back for an encore of just a handful of songs. We save the best for last. Here's our fourth caller, Huck Flynn. Please welcome Huck.
Brian, good to be with you. Really appreciate this opportunity here. Well, as you all know, in April of 74, we had this huge, unbeknownst to us, concert hit our campus. And I've been talking to the two guys who actually booked Bruce for the spring concert show, Stu Blair and Don McNally. At the time, Bruce was like an unknown. They viewed Bruce and his band as this New Jersey great bar band. And that's all they were. They had two albums out, but not much airplay, and Bruce hadn't broke yet. And they had $2,000 left total for the whole spring concert. And Bruce fit budget. But after we booked them, the common response on campus was, you waste our money on Bruce who? We could have had, at the time they were negotiating, Ry Cooter, and Dan Fogelberg was possibly in the running, but he was going to cost too much. And so Bruce got the booking. So on the afternoon of April 28th, 1974, day dawned, the weather was cooperating, it was a gorgeous sunny day. They had contingencies of that was bad weather, the show was going to happen indoors and in Clothier Auditorium there, but gorgeous day. And for the Saturday before reading week, it was in the 70s and just a fantastic day. So as soon as they cranked it up, and they cranked it up, it was loud, and soon people just started, filling into the amphitheater, streaming in. Bruce and Clarence and the band put on a fantastic show, hugely energetic. And of course, towards the end of the show, part of one of their encores, they played a huge, raved up, extended version of Rosalita.
There's some kind of concert here today. You know who's playing? Barely heard his stuff. Think Bruce Springsteen is his name. Could have picked Dan Fogelberg for some amphitheater fun. But together let's break from reading week. Hey, I think the show's begun. Now what's that music I'm hearing, Ruby? This guy seems like he's born to run. Never heard a group like this before, or a singer so unsung. Oh, Ruby, he's the one. Dynamite at all three, baby. Bruce is wearing that cool hat. And his E Street band's got so much energy with the big man on the sax. The day is getting warmer, the pit is filling up. Bruce is racing all around that stage. Hey, some guy just streaked past us. Underneath the trees, singing history, a new rock era had begun. Whether you were there or not that day, for the magic by the crumbs.